Hi, my name is Patrick. This specific video is to give you solutions for the IPMAT 2022 paper. Now, when I'm talking of solution, I'm talking about the way you need to approach the examination. Now, way to approach the aptitude examination is not the way you do mathematically, the way you do your 10th standard, 12th standard examination. You need to look at ways to solve it faster. The moment you understand how to solve it faster, you can save a lot of time, and that will give you more time to solve more questions. Right. So in that case, we'll be looking at approaches as to how to solve questions faster, the right way to solve the aptitude examination so that you can crack the examination and do really well as far as the examination is concerned. So let's look at a question that have actually come in the exam and see what approach to be solved. Now, this is an inequality question. You need to obviously understand the concept. If you understand the concept, it becomes easier to solve. For example, if you know the square bracket means less than equal to, curved bracket means less. For example, here when you say 281, it means 2 less than equal to x less than 81. Because there's a square bracket out here, there's a less than equal to, there's a curved bracket here, there's less than. Now going back to question, if you look at question, there is 1 less than equal to and 1 less than. If the question has 1 less than equal to, technically there should be 1 square bracket and 1 curved bracket. Okay, 1 less than equal to sign and 1 less than. So which means I can eliminate B option and D, C option directly without solving, because B option is both curved bracket. I said there should be at least one curved bracket because of less than sign. And C option is both square bracket. There should be only one square bracket because there's only one less than equal to sign. There's an exception where denominator is zero, but in this case, there's no question of denominator. I can safely assume that there should be one less than equal to sign and one less than sign. So one square bracket, one curved bracket. Now I'm left with two options. Now both has two, but 1, 2 has a curved bracket, 1, 2 has a square bracket. So I'll substitute 2 and check out. Now you will realize that log 8 to the base 27 is nothing but log of 2 cube, 3 cube, which is nothing but 3 upon 3, log of 2 to the base 3, or this becomes log of 2 to the base 3, which means log of 8 to the base 27 is less than equal to log of 2 to the base 3, or is equal to, sorry, equal to 2 to the base 3. That means the minimum value of x out here to equate the first value is 2. That means at 2 there should be equal to sign. Because at 2 there should be equal to sign, I can directly mark the answer as A option and move forward without checking. If you want, you can check with the second value and put x as 81 and check out and see if the value satisfies out here. That is also possible. Just to confirm, I mean, need not do in the exam. In the exam, moment you get the answer A option, you can go ahead with it. But just to help you explain, log of 81 to the base 3 is nothing but log of 3 raised to the power 4 base 3, or 4 log 3 to the base 3, which is 4. Right. Now if I look at 9, what is 9 raised to 1 upon log of base 2 upon 3? When you reverse it, log go up, it becomes log of 2 to the base 3, change of base. Change of base, 9 is nothing but 3 square log of 2 to the base 3, which is nothing but 3 log of 3 2 square. Now there's a formula which you should know, log formula, just know the log formulas. I mean, you have a raised to the power log of a b is nothing but equal to b. So in this case, you will get the answer as 2 square, which is 4, which means you will realize that when I put 81, it becomes equal to the second part, which means no equal to sign. So 81 should not have equal to sign, 2 will have an equal to sign. The answer is A option. The second part was just to confirm, just to explain to you. Otherwise, you can clearly make out there's 1 less than equal to sign, 1 less than sign. So automatically B and C option ruled out. Check with 2. When you put 2, you realize it's same as a less than equal to sign. So that means 2 has to have a square bracket, therefore A option. Next, again function. Again, you need to know fundamentals, and if you understand fundamentals, it's not difficult to solve. Understand 81 base is positive, so anything power will be positive itself. Anything power will be positive, right? So both has to be positive. That means 81 raised to the power of fx has to be less than 3, okay, and has to be more than 0. 81 raised to fx has to be less than 3 because 81 raised to x is positive, so 81 raised to fx has to be less than 3. And because the base is 81 positive, therefore it has to be more than 0. Let's check out, when will it be more than 3? 3 is nothing but Or if you look at 81 is nothing but 3 raised to 4 fx 3. So when will be equal? When 4fx is equal to 1 or fx is equal to 0.25. This is one extreme case. To find an extreme case, you should in inequality equate a value and find out the extreme case. So extreme case is 0.25. Now 0.25 is an A option and C option, which means B and D option ruled out. Okay, the extreme case should be 0.25, A or D option. And obviously cannot have 3 or 2, because the moment I have 3 or 2, 81 ratio 2 becomes much larger than 3. Not possible. So you can directly mark the answer C option, because a very high negative power will give you a very small value of the power. It will be closer to 0. Therefore, C option is the answer. Right? 3 obviously cannot be the answer. With that basis, you can eliminate even A, C and D, because moment A, B and D. Because moment you put x, fx as 2, what it becomes? 81 raised to 2. 81 raised to 2 plus whatever positive value will be definitely more than 81 square. Cannot be the answer. So you can actually eliminate A, C and D option, A, B and D option. Directly you'll get the answer C. Don't even have to do these calculations. So if you understand the fundamentals, it becomes easier to solve. You need to understand the basic fundamentals. And the moment you understand the fundamentals, you can actually solve it quickly, understanding it. The value of K for which following lines are congruent. Congruent means the same, passes to same point. Now here what you can do is, you can actually solve, because you can draw also and get the answer, but drawing may take extra time. You can, but okay. A easier way is to solve the equation. Solve the first, second equation. I mean, do simultaneous equation. Let's say I am multiplying the first equation by 2. So 2x minus 2y minus 2 equal to 0. And the second equation is 2x plus 3y minus 12 equal to 0. Subtract. So 2, second equation minus first equation. X will get cancelled. We'll get 5y minus 10 equal to 0. We'll get y equal to 2. The moment you get y equal to 2, put in one of the equation, x minus 2 minus 1 equal to 0, you'll get x as 3. Substitute in the third equation. So 2 into 3 minus 3 into 2 plus k equal to 0. So you'll realize 0 is equal to k. C option. You need to be a little good in calculation. If you're fast in calculation, you can actually solve things quickly. The length of the sides. Again, conceptually, you need to be clear. It's not difficult concepts, simple concepts. The concept is sum of two sides has to be more than third sides. In a triangle, sum of two sides has to be more than third side. As long as you know this, you can directly get the answer as 20. But any other option, for example, 19 if I take, 19 plus 21 is not more than 40. Sum of two sides has to be more than third side. To satisfy that constraint, you'll directly mark the answer as B option. So understanding the basic concepts helps you think, solve things faster. Once you understand the basic concepts, it's more of application of that concept that will help you to do things. If you solve things mathematically, it will take you a longer time and you may not be able to get enough marks to crack the exam. So look out for ways, look out for shortcut methods, look out for approaches, how you can solve faster, and that will give you that push for the extra marks. Thank you.